another video, and today we have another NFL predictions view. Week number 9 in the NFL. I don't know how it's week 9 already, but it is. So, yeah. Last week, though, just terrible, god-awful, worst, horrific, trash, dude. Another terrible week, went 6-9. I don't understand it anymore. That would bring up my record to 62-58-1 on the total for this season. Still keeping my head above 500 somehow. I don't know how, but I am. I need a big week this week, so let's just get right into it. The teams on the bye this week, we got a lot of them. We got the Browns, the Giants, the Steelers, the Broncos, the Cowboys, and the 49ers. So it should be an interesting week. Not many games, so hopefully I can get more right this week. Hopefully. Kicking it off with the Thursday night matchup, you have the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Houston Texans. The Eagles, they are the best team in the NFC, undoubtedly. They are still undefeated, 7-0. And they're playing the trash Texans. The Texans lost to the Titans last week. And they suck. They're trash. They're garbage. Damian Pierce is, like, the only player on that team. Davis Mills, I think, might have gotten injured, too. So, they're just screwed on every level. So, I'm going to take the Eagles. Pretty simple. I'm saying they're still undefeated after this week, going 8-0. Calling it. Taking the Eagles on Thursday night. Then you have the Sunday games, starting with the Vikings at the Commanders. The Vikings barely got a win against the Cardinals last week. Their defense played amazing. Probably the best I've seen this Vikings defense play, honestly. And then the Commanders. Commanders, what'd they do? They might have had a bye. I don't think so. The Commanders barely beat the Colts. That's right. I'm going to take the Vikings here. The Vikings, they're just looking really good right now. 6-1. You know, the Commanders, maybe they pull off an upset, but I don't think so, sadly. I want the Commanders to win, but I don't think they will. So I'm taking the Vikings. Colts at the Patriots. The Colts, as we talked about, lost to the Commanders. And then the Patriots somehow win against the Jets. Honestly, they probably shouldn't have won that game. But, you know, it is what it is. The Colts, they start Sam Ehlinger last week. I don't know if Matt Ryan's going to start. They have so many issues with that team. But the Patriots aren't looking great either. I don't know, honestly. I honestly don't know. I'm gonna take the Patriots. I'm gonna play it safe. It's Billy Belichick. Billy Belichick is just that guy, pal. So I'm taking the Patriots. Getting to the Dolphins at the Bears. The Dolphins were able to barely squeak off a win against the Lions last week. The Bears, I think they had a bye week last week. Oh, no, they lost to the Cowboys. They got destroyed by the Cowboys. That's right. How can I forget them just getting murdered by the Cowgirls? Tua looked pretty good last week. I mean, Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle, they're just those guys, pal. They're so friggin' good. Tua made a lot of underthrows, but so, I think the Dolphins can get the win in this one. Bears aren't just looking good at all. So, I'm taking the Dolphins. The Bills at the Jets. The Bills, they beat my Green Bay Packers on Sunday Night Football. We don't have to talk about it. Josh Allen looked pretty good until the end where he started throwing a couple interceptions. But at that point, they had the win in the bag. Stephon Diggs, I don't want to talk about it. The Jets, they lost to the Patriots, as we were talking about. I don't know, honestly. I think it could be maybe a closer game than we think. But the Bills are the best team in the AFC, in my opinion. I think they're arguably the best team in the league. I mean, you could make an argument for the Chiefs, you could make an argument for the Eagles, but I think the Bills are just, they're really good. I think they're just so good. I think that one loss against the Dolphins in one of the earlier weeks was just a fluke. The Jets are looking pretty good too, but I think they might start going on a losing streak now, with starting last week's game. So I'm going to take the Bills. The Chargers at the Falcons. The Chargers, I don't remember what they did last week. I think they had a bye. They did have a bye. The Chargers had a bye week last week. And then the Falcons, oh my God, dude. Crazy game, dude. I had the Falcons in that game, but dude, at that point, the Falcons got lucky so many times, it's not even funny. Younghoe Koo is the GOAT. So yeah, Falcons getting another win. I think this is a winnable game for the Chargers, though. I think coming off a bye, Justin Herbert ready to go, and I think with Keenan Allen possibly being healthy now, after the bye, I think it's pretty good for the Chargers and the Falcons. This is one of their big tests for this season, and I think it'll be too big of a test. So I'm going to take the Chargers. The Panthers at the Bengals. The Panthers, they lost to the Falcons, as we said. Oh, my God, dude. The Panthers, DJ Moore, run. Run far away from Carolina. Just run. Just run away. Just run as far away as you can from Carolina, because, yeah, it's rough. Eddie Pinheiro sucks. Cut him. The Bengals, they lost on Monday night. I don't know what happened there with the Bengals. I guess the Browns were just playing a better game. I guess they just were. But I think the Bengals facing not a great team at all in the Panthers. I think the Panthers are one of the worst teams in the league. I think the Bengals can get a bit of redemption here. I know the Panthers team actually looked pretty good last week. But I don't think that'll last long. I'm taking the Bengals. You get to my Green Bay Packers taking on the Detroit Lions. My Packers, we lost. Yeah, we lost. Yeah, I get it. We lost. Not shocking, but still just disappointing at the same time. There's a lot of positives to take out of that game, though. Our running game looked amazing. Aaron Jones is that guy, pal. AJ Dillon is that guy, pal. Our defense looked okay, not great at all, but we got a lot of just mishaps with the injuries and Devondre Campbell. I don't know the update on him. Hopefully he's doing well and can play, because the middle of the field started to get really targeted a lot after, one, the Devondre Campbell injury, and then the ejection of Quay Walker. We know Quay Walker will be back in this game, but it's still just disappointing. And then the Lions, they lost to the Dolphins, as we said earlier on. Lions looked pretty good the entire game. Their defense looked really good in the second half, or in the first half. And then the second half hit, and it was god-awful. Their defense just freaking let up everything. Their offense couldn't do nothing, which usually that's the strong suit of the Lions. The offense can usually do a lot of things. That second half hit, and they put up, like, all their points in the first half and just couldn't do anything for the rest of the game. Maybe it's just because the Dolphins' defense really came up clutch. I don't know. But if my Packers do what we did in that second half of the, Bills game, we should be able to win this game. We should target the poor defensive Lions and just run the ball up their throats. I know they had that one middle linebacker. I forgot his name. But he looked pretty good last week. But yeah. I'm hoping that this Packers team can finally get in the winning column. We are in a 4-game losing streak. We're 3-5, tied for, I think, third worst third best in the NFC North. We need a win here, and we got to take advantage of a poor team like the Lions. So let's get the dub. Go, Pack, go. Going for my Packers. Next up, you have the Raiders at the Jaguars. The Raiders, embarrassing, dude. How do you lose to the Saints? The Jaguars, embarrassing, dude. How do you lose to the Broncos? I need to stop. But seriously, embarrassing for both teams. I mean, the Jaguars looked fine, and then Trevor Lawrence just couldn't do anything. It was kind of a back-and-forth battle, but still, it's just a little disappointing when Trevor Lawrence needs to play just a lot better than that, especially in front of the Jaguars' hometown in London. And then the Raiders, they lost to the Saints. Shut out. That's even more embarrassing, dude. How do you get shut out by the Saints? Like, their defense isn't even that good. Couldn't do a thing. Derek Carr, Davante Adams, Tay, I still love you. But y'all suck. Y'all suck. Honestly, though, I don't know, man. I kind of feeling Jaguars, dude. I'm low-key feeling Jaguars. Like, the Jaguars on a 5-game losing streak. It's... See, this is why I barely get any games right every week. But I'm just like, I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be copyright. Yeah. I just got this feeling. That I think the Jaguars can win this. I know the Raiders are 2-5 and the Raiders have not looked good at all, but I think this is a winnable game for the Jaguars. I really think it is, but I also think it's a winnable game for the Raiders. Oh, do I play it safe and go the Raiders? I think I might play it safe and go the Raiders. Is it really playing safe at this point, though? It's in Jacksonville. You know what? I'm not trying to lose every game freaking this week. So I'm going to go with the Raiders. But if I get this game wrong and the Jaguars win, don't tell you that I didn't try, okay? Because I want to go with the Jaguars, but I can't. So quote me, the Jaguars are probably going to win. But I'm going with the Raiders. The Seahawks at the Cardinals. The Seahawks, they won last week. I don't understand. I don't understand this Seahawks team. They're 5-3. They're number one in the division. Nothing makes sense. This team was supposed to be one of the worst in the league. Sorry. The Cardinals, they lost barely last week. Their offense just couldn't get anything going in those big time clutch moments. These two teams already faced earlier this season, and recently actually too. I only think it was like 2 weeks ago. The Seahawks won. It's in Arizona. Oh, Geno just looks so good. I'm going to say we have a fire Kyler Murray and DeAndre Hopkins day, and they just go balls to the walls like they did a couple weeks on Thursday night where they just do everything. So I'm going to go with the Cardinals. I think after Kyler Murray playing his COD, I think he's a little more motivated now to actually play football. So I'm taking the Cardinals. The Rams at the Buccaneers. The Rams, they lost last week, got murdered by the 49ers. They're on a big time Super Bowl hangover if I've ever seen it. And the Bucks, they're on a big time Super Bowl a couple years ago hangover. Obviously, back to back, the past two Super Bowl winners, and they've just not looked good. these two teams have just not looked great. Tom Brady is washed. He should have just listened to Giselle. Should have just retired, settled with his 7 rings. He wouldn't have got divorced with Giselle. He wouldn't have gotten freaking plastic surgery. And he would have been fine. And he would have gone on his merry way. He would have been put in the Hall of Fame in a couple years. And life would be good. But no. He had to come back. I'm going to take the Rams here. The Rams, honestly, on offense, have just looked terrible. And they don't have Cooper Kupp. But I think... I don't know, man. I just think this is a big-time game for the Rams that they need to win, and I think they will win. They're coming... they're coming off a bye. They are not coming off a bye. They had a bye last week, the week before. But I'm going to take the Rams. Screw it. Next up, you have the Titans at the Chiefs on Sunday Night Football. Two really powerhouse teams here. Titans, Derrick Henry, he's him. Derrick Henry, he's him. He's so good, dude. Literally the biggest monster. That man isn't human. He is a monster. Not a human, a monster. And then the Chiefs, they had a bye week last week. So good time for them to regroup here. So I'm going to take the Chiefs. I just don't think the Titans should be this good. I think they've had an easy schedule. I think they've had a really easy schedule, and the Chiefs haven't really, but I think the Chiefs are just one of the best teams in the league, so I'm gonna take the Chiefs. It's in Arrowhead. I'm taking them, but you never know. Derrick Henry could just run over the Chiefs defense and call it a day, but I'm taking the Chiefs still. Getting to the Monday night game, you have the Baltimore Ravens taking on the New Orleans Saints. The Ravens... they won last week, beating the Buccaneers, Lamar Jackson. I still think Lamar Jackson is up there for MVP possibility. I think he's him. He's him. The Saints, they destroyed the Raiders. No one cares. I'm going to take the Ravens. The Saints' offense looks really good. But I just think the Ravens' offense just looks a little bit better. So I'm going to take the Saints. I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. I'm going to get this edited and posted out to you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Bye, guys. Way up, we go.